In this video, I'm showing you the equipment I use to produce HD or 4K streams on my desktop using a mirrorless camera or DSLR camera. Coming up. Hey everybody, and welcome back to Premiere Gal. If you guys are new here, consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell so you're notified when we publish new educational videos about video editing and production every week. So in this video, I'm gonna show you what equipment you need to produce a high quality stream, then how to hook it up correctly to your computer on your desktop, and then we're gonna jump into the software. You can use a free OBS software, you can use Wirecast, BeLive TV to stream just to Facebook. I'm gonna jump into all of those and show you how to use them correctly so you can get started streaming. So let's jump in. Here I have the Joby GorillaPod connected to the Canon M3 mirrorless camera. And it has an M to EF mount adapter for the lens. It's a wide angle lens. It's a 10 to 18 millimeter. Another thing that I want to stress is that you don't have to use a mirrorless or DSLR camera. You can certainly use a wide angle Logitech webcam, but this is cooler because you can have interchangeable lenses to create different looks. Wide angle is great for desk setups because you're able to get a wider view, so that way the lens isn't really close up in somebody's face. So you should certainly explore other options. This is just the camera that I currently own that I use in all of my YouTube videos. And so it's just convenient to not have to buy another camera to use as a high quality streaming camera. Next, you'll need some type of microphone. I have an SL600 USB condenser microphone that can connect directly to my computer via USB. Also, with this USB condenser microphone, you can get an optional pop filter, so that way it reduces the pops and clicks as you speak. So I definitely recommend getting this. Of course, you don't have to get this particular model. You can use any USB condenser microphone. There's tons on Amazon and on B&H. So this is just the one that I have, but I don't want to limit you to just this one. There's definitely other options out there. And then to connect the camera to the computer, you're going to need an HDMI cable. And the most important part is cam link. You can't just hook up your camera via USB and expect it to work as an HD webcam. You need some sort of capture card or a converter like this, cam link, to convert it into an unlimited stream camera. So that way you can stream without your camera turning off, right? So this just plugs into your computer via USB and you put in the HDMI cable, connect it to your camera, and it does that for you. Now, Elgato is the producer of this. It's a gaming equipment company. So you can go check out some of their capture cards and you can look up to see if your camera is compatible with Cam Link. If your camera's not listed, you can reach out to the Elgato team and they should be able to get back to you. But this is one piece of awesome equipment, and I think it costs around $120, but it's definitely worth it. I have the mini HDMI here, so what I'm going to do is just plug it in to the side of this camera here like so. Make sure that you're putting it in the correct way. You don't want it to get ruined here. So now that we have the HDMI cabled in the camera, the next step is connecting the other end of the HDMI cable, in my case, the full HDMI, into the back of the cam link here. Okay, so there's a little HDMI input here and the USB end goes into the computer. So I'm going to connect this into my cam link right now, like so. So now that that's connected, we can put this into the computer and set up the stream. So I have my USB condenser microphone. It's an SL600 by Editor's Keys. It has a cable that connects in the bottom here, USB, and it connects directly into my computer. So let me just hook this up now. And I almost forgot, you guys should get some type of light to help illuminate your face during the stream. I have this LED light by Newer here, and it's bi-color, so you can make it more of an orange color or more of a white color or a mixture of both. There's dimmable switches on the back, so I can make this more orange by turning off the white or I can make it a mixture like this, or turn off the orange-ish look to make it just white. And you can also get a light stand separately. Right now I'm at a standing desk, so I can make this fully extended while I'm standing and doing a live stream, and it's really easy to use. And that way I don't have to worry about putting another tripod for a light on my desk. So the first step is to make sure that the framing of the camera looks good before you actually jump into the software. If you try to turn on the Canon M3 right now, it'll only flash on for a second. That's because when it's connected via the HDMI, it turns off the live view functionality. So before you plug in this HDMI, it's good to unplug it first, just temporarily, and then you can use the flip up feature on the M3 here, so you can see that I'm looking at myself right now, and you can make sure that the framing of the shot looks good. And because it's a wide angle, you see a lot of the shot. I can zoom in as much as I want here until I get the framing right. Then once everything looks good, then you can plug back in the HDMI. So I'm gonna hit record off because we're not gonna be recording during the live stream, okay? So let's just turn that off and let's plug this back in. All right. Now we need to jump in and show you how to use the live broadcasting software, hook it up to your YouTube or Facebook account so you can get started streaming and have that nice picture. So first up is OBS. So OBS is open broadcasting software. It can be used on a Mac or a PC. Right now when you open it up, the window is very empty. There's not much going on. Well, first we need to add our video capture source. So you're gonna go down here to sources and hit the plus button and go to video capture device. And you can call it whatever you want. I'm gonna call it M3 since that's my camera. Then I'll hit okay. And then from device, we have to choose cam link because cam link is the one that's connecting us right now. So now you can immediately see it. And the options we have are 1280 to 720 for HD. So we're gonna select that and hit okay. And here, what we can do is make this bigger or smaller to fill up the frame. And you can see that I'm kind of out of focus. So this is when you can make adjustments on screen here like so. So you can see it and do the best you can until it's just right, like so. So then you can make further adjustments if you want to make it more side. The beauty of the wide angle is that you can kind of play around with the angle. It's kind of a funny angle there. I think that looks good. You can kind of see my computer. So again, you can adjust framing again until it looks right. And then I think that I look a little bright, so I'm just going to adjust the lights real quick. So then for audio, we want to connect this audio source. So we're going to go down to plus and go to audio input capture. And here I'm going to call it my SL600 and hit okay. And here I'm going to select USB microphone because that is the microphone, the SL600. And then hit okay, and then immediately you start to see input levels here on the screen, which is awesome because that means that it's active. And right now, if I talk really loud, then you get that sort of red mark and you don't want that. You want it to be in the green. So now we have the image and we have the SL600 microphone. So all we need to do now, if we wanted to stream, right? If we wanted to stream, we would have to go up to OBS preferences. And here is where you put in your stream info. So here is where you choose the service. If I want to stream to YouTube, I'm going to choose YouTube. You can also choose Twitch, Facebook Live, Twitter, Periscope. Those are the most common. But after you do that, you need to change the key. And this is the private information, and you don't want to share this key with anybody else, but you can show it. I'm not going to show it because I actually have my stream key in here. And the way that you do that is you actually go to your YouTube back end. So if I go to YouTube and then you go to your creator studio, then you're gonna go to live streaming. And here is where you're going to basically set up the title, the description of your stream. So you can put in any links that you have here, description. You can choose the category. You can choose if you want it to be private to test for the first time. unlisted or public. I'd recommend doing it private for the first time. And then once you're 100% sure, you can do public. And this is where you can see your chat as well. And down at the bottom, this is where you get your stream key. So you would just reveal it and then copy it. And then you go back to OBS and you paste that stream key here. And then you hit OK. So notice that the stream video went off when we were doing that. Well, we actually have to change some settings in the camera to fix that. So what I'm going to do is just turn the camera back on again. And you can actually see what is on the screen inside of OBS because the HDMI cable is giving you a preview of what you see. And if you hit the info button, it'll show you different overlays and you can turn them off by hitting that info button. And I'm not seeing anything on the screen of my M3 right now. I'm just pressing the buttons and I'm seeing everything on OBS. So I'm gonna go to menu right now and I'm going to use the scroller over here just to navigate to the wrench tool here. And then I'm going to move to power saving. And this is where we wanna change this so the M3 doesn't auto power down on us after a couple minutes, right? So we wanna change this to off. So that way the M3 doesn't turn off while we're in the middle of the stream, okay? So every settings for different cameras are different. So this is just for the M3. There's different settings for turning off the overlays. So for example, if I exit menu, you see all these overlays here. Some cameras have a menu setting called HDMI output, which allow you to turn off all of those settings. But on M3, you just hit the info button to remove those, which is something I had to figure out just by messing with the settings. Now that we have YouTube set up, we have the camera settings good, we can actually start streaming right now and it'll automatically connect to YouTube. And then what will happen is you'll get some notifications at the bottom here to see the frame rate, what percentage of your CPU is being used, how many gigabytes per second, and you can see how long that you've been live for. And if we go to YouTube, you can see that we're now live from the desktop and you can get a preview of the live stream. Right now I'm private, but if I was public, you would see all of the, you know, people asking questions or people saying hi. So right now, this is how you stream in OBS. Let me just stop the streaming here. Another option is to use BeLive.tv for Facebook Live. And all you have to do is connect your account and then you hit start broadcasting. And here you can choose whether or not you want to do solo, an interview with another person, a talk show with multiple people. So I'm going to select solo. And by the way, this is a trial mode right now. So there is a monthly fee that you'd have to pay to use this for certain features per month, but you can have, I believe, a 14-day trial to test it out. So I'm going to click on solo. And then I'm gonna choose on a page that I manage, which is Premier Gal. So it'll connect, I'll do Premier Gal, and then you can type in some text, and then you can choose to share it with somebody, add your branding, so you can add in your logo, or change the branding colors if you wanted it to be more like a purple color, and then hit Save Branding, and then create your broadcast. And here is where you connect your camera. So you have to click on this gear icon to make it's the right one. And then what we're going to do is make sure we have the right microphone in and it's giving you a preview that, you know, we're picking up audio, which is good. So this is my SL600. Then I'm just going to hit save and reconnect camera. And then you would hit start broadcast and then you can write on screen updates if you want to. So say hello. And then you can show that and it'll be in your branding. So that's how you use BeLive. I think it's awesome. I just wish it also went to YouTube as well. So that's my live stream setup and that's how I do high quality live streams to my YouTube channel and Facebook page. If you guys have another way of streaming or another piece of gear that you use, I'd love to hear about it. Be sure to leave a comment below. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if it helped you out. Subscribe and hit that notification bell so you're notified when we publish new videos here. That's all and I'll see you guys next week. Bye.